According to the credible Apple analyst Ming-Chi Kuo, iPhone 14 and 14 Max are going to get a year-old processor chip. At the end of 2020, I made a video called Apple just made the most anti-consumer move ever and nobody cares. In that video, I addressed how Apple is removing the charging brick from its boxes to help the environment. It all started in 2016 when they removed the headphone jack, then they removed the charging brick, and now potentially charging same price for their reused flagships. The worst part is Android manufacturers are going to shamelessly copy all of this, and for a good reason, because this generates additional revenue. I can summarize all of Apple's business model and as a result Android's business model in one sentence. Good for business, but not for consumers. We can look at it and say, well, Apple chips are way more powerful and future-proof, so it's not a big deal that they might want to use it in their future phones. It's not like we can throw a workload on it that it might not handle. Additionally, the tight software hardware integration in iOS is also top-notch, so we won't notice any lag. Also, according to some rumors, Apple might reuse its telephoto camera sensor. Well, hey, it's a really good sensor. And software optimizations can make it perform even better than the last iterations. Only Pro Max variant is going to get latest and greatest in terms of hardware. Okay, but why would Apple do this aside from generating additional revenue? It's because of lack of competition. While it is true that Android manufacturers hold most of the market share worldwide, Apple doesn't have an eligible competitor in the chip department. 4 to 6 years back, Apple felt the hit from Android, and then they categorized their offerings into different price points. A once premium flagship manufacturer was now making devices for flagship enthusiasts and mid-range rockers. Without competition, companies want to reuse its assets because why not? Don't believe me? Intel did the exact same thing a couple of years back. They were sticking to the 14 nanometer chip for dear life. Every year there was a new chip, but with very slight performance gains. But when AMD started sweeping market shares and manufacturers, they then introduced effective new architecture. We can also look at it and interpret it as bad value for the consumer. I mean, think about it. Same price point for a new flagship with old hardware, less future-proof device, at least 1 year less in theory. The so-called environmentally friendly company can ditch their non-Pro Max offerings altogether to make a huge positive impact on the environment, and people can buy old devices that are already in rotation or are much more sustainable to produce. In the bigger picture of things, this is going to be set as a precedent for smartphones. Android makers are going to reuse their processors and charges the same price. These chips are not on the same level as Bionic chips. Same camera hardware also suffers from the same dilemma. Another argument is the new iPhones coming will mean the old ones will drop in price, and as they're basically the same device, we can buy the old one cheaper. Yes, but even if they came with the newer chips, the old iPhones would have still dropped in price. Some of its practices are so counterintuitive to their proposed initiatives that it's just fascinating. They were fined in Brazil for removing the charger. EU is now forcing Apple to include USB-C port. No more royalties on lightning cables sold, but I'm certain they'll find a way. For me, the consumer-friendly era was from 2013 to 2018. In this period, most competitors were focused on adding as many features as possible in their flagships, trying to offer more things at the same price point. Don't get me wrong, we have foldables, flippables, and better hardware, but it all comes at the cost of making decisions that are better for businesses and not for us consumers. In a nutshell, innovation has been great, but bang for the buck has dropped drastically, at least for flagships. Some mid-ranger and low-end manufacturers that are not well-known are still offering a lot with their devices. I hope that we can keep up this innovation, Apple can get some serious competition, and Android differentiate themselves on behalf of different value propositions. In the end, this will all be useful for us consumers. With that being said, this is Roghead. I hope you guys enjoyed this perspective. Thank you so much for watching. Catch you guys later.